Oh no, like the chat would only be able to hear us coming out of his headphones. The last couple times I've streamed with Nick, that's what happened. That's what's happened. Ever since he spilled water on his computer.
I switched over. The audio wasn't muted. Hello, everybody. Welcome to Today We Suffer with me, Nick Calandra, Marty, and KC.
Spicy water is just
some water. It's not exciting. Red Bull is like tasty gasoline.
Yeah. Is this game gonna cause me a pain in the ass just to stream it?
Does that man not look like Nick?
The man in the game.
Am I tripping right now?
The man in the game looks a little bit like Nick. Nick, did you create this character?
I did not. I don't have all these scars on my face.
This is Gruff War Nick.
Yeah, this is you after you've seen some shit.
I mean, yeah.
Jobly says we're muted.
We are coming out of your headphones.
Fuck.
We've already called it.
I fucking fixed it.
Damn.
Oh. You've just not been on the ball in the last 10 minutes. What's going on? You're yawning a bunch?
It's fixed.
It was
different for some reason. It pulled a different scene when I changed the audio, so it's working now.
Incredible. Can they hear us?
Yeah, unfortunately. Well,
what's up everybody? This is our punishment stream. Somehow this is our combined punishment. I'm just sitting here, which is great, but for our E3/Summer Game Fest bingo, which Casey won, the punishment that we have to play Hunt Down the Freeman, the 2018 fan mod game set during the events of Half-Life, where you play a soldier trying to hunt down the Freeman. And I looked on its Wikipedia, and under reception, it says the reviews were primarily negative, including Ben Yahtzee Croshaw of The Escapist, who was similarly negative towards the game in a zero punctuation review, criticizing its plot, voice acting, graphics, level design, and poor implementation of several core mechanics. He would later rank Hunt Down the Freeman as being the worst game of 2018 and the worst game of the entire 2010s, barring Ride to Hell Retribution, which he refused to rank. Was that like a political protest? What do you mean he refused to rank?
Okay, I think I fixed everything now. They were saying there was echo, but I think it was just coming out of my headphones because
that'd have been really funny if I didn't have any audio during that. Just pretend I was telling Casey all that stuff.
I mean, it was great information. I'll remember it forever.
Does any of this seem familiar to you, Casey? As a new Half-Life Half-Life expert, any of this seem familiar?
No, this ain't the lab, right? Like this is.
Oh, this is someone's living room.
Yeah, the entirety of the first game is just black.
Yeah, you were never like drinking brewskis out in the.
This is
on the alley.
This game.
This is some.
Okay, I will fix the overlay in a second. This game does not like to be streamed for some reason. That is a scary looking man.
Yeah, but the overlay looks fine.
Casey's mouth frozen. Was all on your eyeball.
I have to fix it because Casey's frozen.
Oh no.
Oh, I thought he was just doing that.
I mean, I can't just leave it there as his punishment.
What am I being punished for? I'm the winner.
He's a winner. I should be the one frozen. I'm going to be honest. So far, this is a pretty solid opening cutscene. I'm not hearing anything, but I'm assuming
I don't hear anything either.
I'm assuming it's beautiful.
Pretty trite, but not bad. Sam Fisher doing here?
Yeah, that's like, should you call your bosses and tell them to, if Valve didn't get the legal action on this, maybe you guys can?
No, he's legally distinct. Only one.
Oh my god, that was really violent.
Yeah, the first stab in the neck probably would have done it, I think.
Oh, it's a Burke and Dennis Zavizian game. Well, I don't know why you guys never told us that. Oh, We're in.
Oh, damn, we're right into it.
Okay, now I have to go fix some things.
And you have to get your controller, because we on Thursday nights we play on controllers. And as you guys can see in the corner, we are over 82% the way towards side quest 3, with just a couple days left. Thank you guys so much to everyone who donated. Thank you to so many of the green members and the patrons in chat, and just all the regulars we see every Thursday. We appreciate it.
Why did Casey freeze again? What the fuck?
Yeah, my camera's doing something weird. It was like, okay, it's I have movement, it looks like.
Yeah, no, as soon as I go back to the game, you freeze.
Is that, and just me? Yeah. Marty doesn't freeze, just me freeze.
Yeah, just you.
What is that about?
That's wild. Okay, whatever, I'm playing this in windowed mode.
that's brand new. If you've ever streamed, that doesn't make any fucking sense.
Oh my god, the game's racist. we found a racist game.
I think switching to windowed mode meant the game crashed too.
I'm glad this is working out.
Gildan, your donation is absolutely not too boring to read. Your $5 donation is much appreciated. Robin Wild, welcome to Early Access. Thank you so much, Robin. And Gildan with a $5 dono. Better you guys than me. Here's what I know. At least initially pitched for crowdfunding through Indiegogo with a goal of $100,000. Only $12 were raised. That's humbling. That's a real humbling. Oh, Royal Radius Entertainment.
The game still got made, though.
Yeah. With just, if you can make a 100,000 game,
I tried to load it, now it crashed again.
We just open up a Let's Play and just watch it for the next 2 hours.
No, this is the punishment. Nick, you have to play this game.
I mean, to be fair, Casey had to go through similar things with
Spirits Carnivores. Invade my PC.
Yeah, with Carnivores.
This isn't just a bad game. It's just a badly everything game. I got an achievement for.
Oh, congrats.
What the fuck? It cracked. Like, that was an achievement. That they built that into the game to. Oh, I did it again. Programmed in one last crash for all time style. One or two more crashes. What?
Wait, it's a story thing?
Oh, no.
That's incredible.
I just got an achievement for it.
That's actually really good.
Is this game secretly brilliant? Is that what?
Yeah, is this like a subversive Doki Doki Frog Fractions? Wing Potato with a $4.99 dono. Thank you so much. The real punishment is the streaming issues. This is genius. I'm genuinely floored by this. And then Layton, been a member for 24 months, 2 years. Thank you so much, Layton. Would just like to thank you, Nick, and everyone on the team for turning the Escapist around and providing content I enjoy watching besides zero punctuation. Really enjoying Stuff of Legends. Hell yeah, Layton. That's yeah, awesome.
I just watched the third episode before it goes out to members on Monday. It's so good.
Ooh, yeah. Check out episode 2. It went up earlier this week. I'm going to toss in the link. Yeah, get excited. Members get episode 3 next week. And then Dower Dodger gifted 20. Count them. 2-0 subs. 2 members, including Billy Donuts, David Dubois, Yedem, Red King, Wraithbow, Bearded Bunny, Shantau, Silent Knight, Loki Aiki, Kados, Shapiro, Milk Dirt, Louise, The Re, Light Arkin, Hell Knight, David of the Port, Rob Roland. Was there more? No, Chaos Slayer, and Greg Tortle, and Duncan Dixon Curry. Dixon Curry.
For several of those names, you added L's where L's did not exist.
Oh, did I?
That did not say Milk Dirt.
Oh, it looked like it says Milk Dirt.
And that did not say Greg Tortle.
You got a disease where when I drink too many liquids, I start adding L's to things. Greg Tortle. That's my favorite starting Pokemon.
Game is working.
Nick, what
now.
Do you think so far?
I don't know.
It just seems like a shooter.
How does it feel?
It feels better than normal Half-Life.
You heard it here first. Hunt down the Freeman better than Half-Life.
Nick, what's your experience with Half-Life? Did you play them like when you were younger? Did you play them like?
No, recently. I've only played Alex and 1 and 2, but I haven't finished episode 1 and 2 yet.
Yeah, you can skip 1.
You skip one. Not a lot happens. Two's pretty
one
cool.
One is a complete waste of time.
There you go. quintuple A with a 499 dono. Thank you so much, quintuple. Feels like this punishment is incomplete without cat ears. We should have got you a little turkey popcorn man, like a little hat. They probably made like stuffed hats of head crabs, right?
You should be wearing the hat if I gotta play the game.
Oh, gladly. Give me a stuffed popcorn hat. Give me the thing I just made up.
You just buy like a little rubber chicken or something. Wear that on your head.
Same yeah, thing. I'm gonna be honest, it's kind of late for that.
What if every time I die, I get to slap Marty with a rubber chicken? That seems awesome.
I'm trying to figure out why is my head being cut off.
Jump
the camera. I'm moving my
wall,
camera. I'm
using space and keep holding space to walk.
Yeah, you gotta go all the way to Wisconsin and slap me with a chicken. And Umbajug, welcome to bonus content. Thank you so much. Didn't add any L's there, did I, Casey? Nope. Got them all out of my system.
This wants me to. It says I can wall run now.
Oh my what? God.
But it just
there was never a soldier.
Wait, the instruction is only here though. I have to stand like in that pile of blood, jump towards the wall using space, and keep holding space to wall climb higher.
Climb. It's
climb
like a
up. Okay.
So just do they mean hold space? So like run towards it, press space to jump, and keep it pressed down the whole time.
And
Calm just says you have to holster your weapon, which I guess makes sense.
Yeah, you can't climb a wall. Though.
That technically makes sense.
That makes a lot
there
of sense.
There is logic in Dostoevsky's game. I don't remember what his name was, and I feel bad that I forgot it already.
Ben Shapirinsky.
He did not like the Barbie movie, let me tell you. Birkin Denizarian. Hello, Birkin.
So the whole thing is a one-man jam?
There's a composer, Paul Humphrey.
How's the music sound? I can't hear anything.
There is no
sound
music.
Beautiful.
Right now.
Who needs music?
Oh, yeah, that's true. One honestly didn't have that much music.
No. Maybe he's playing as one of those ninja assassins. Remember the ninja assassins? They were like stealthy.
Yeah, they...
They were doing shimmies.
They were in like two sections out of that entire game. They had like stealth tech.
Okay. Oh, you can just.
So this isn't like Perfect Dark counter-operative mode where like there is a Gordon Freeman running around that you have to find.
That's a good question. I don't know. It'd be exciting if there was. Like, I'm assuming we're in Black Mesa now, right? Like,
This looks like. Yeah, I think that's the logo on the wall up there too.
Okay.
I think you're in Black Mesa. Yeah.
George Lucas says, we're early on, so anything goes, but this might be better than Redfall.
Sure.
Nick, did you finish Gears of War?
I did.
Congrats.
They're all dead.
Nice. Did you finish the Aftermath campaign?
I did not.
Are you going to play that next week?
No.
What are you going to play next week?
Was it bad? What happened?
Secret.
It's a secret? Oh, yeah, you said there was a secret 360 game he was going to play, and he wouldn't tell me what it was.
Yes.
Is it Vigilante 8?
No, that's PlayStation.
Yeah, that game is not on 360.
We were trying to trick you.
You can only trick yourself. Oh, that was there was a knife, or didn't even know it was there in the prologue. And I also got an achievement called Fucked Face.
Wait, with a... Like, fucked, like, the past tense face? I don't even understand that.
Oh, hey.
Oh, wait.
Oh, was that Gordon?
Was that Gordon? Just kicked me in the face.
I didn't know he had a helmet with that suit. You look like Master Chief.
Yeah, weren't we always non-helmety?
I don't think so. I think in the first game he was helmety.
he's
murdering me.
I don't remember this part. When did Gordon...
Oh, you don't remember when we just tortured this man like a saw victim?
Whoever it takes, however long it takes before I die, I will fucking
oh my god.
You.
Revenge. This is like Kill Bill. Oh, this would be a good place for the title screen.
So those scars on his face, Gordon gave him those?
I got those from Crowbar and kicked the face.
It's revenge.
Yeah, Gordon looked a lot like a Spartan, which is weird because there's probably... No, I guess there's not a Gordon model because you don't see Gordon ever. So there's probably not like a really good Gordon model like there is an Alex or a, you know...
Sure.
whatever his name is, this dude, G-Man.
Yikes. His face is kind of creepy. I didn't need to see that.
Why is G-Man taking interest in this bloke? I do have
to admit, he's trying to use him to in his battle against Gordon, with Gordon, for Gordon. To be honest, I still don't know his relationship to Gordon. Yet you are still
here. You should have just died there. But that's their Facebook stuff. You've proven yourself a
man. Rare conviction. Yeah, look at his name. His name in the subtitles. They're doing little wiggles. That's clever.
Yeah, it's just G-Man, like, scrolling real fast, right?
Yeah. So far, I find this game delightful. I think it has clever.
Yeah, it has not committed any atrocities so far.
Yeah. Before I die,
I will kill you. We are only 15 minutes in, though, to be fair.
Maybe we'll get one of those noises as loud as either A, the carnivore noise, or B, the pineapple on pizza trailer playing several times during Slightly Something Else this week, and just blisteringly loud jump scares. I want to see what this guy's voice is. Like, it's obviously not the voice actor, right?
Shit. I'm losing too much blood. I need to patch myself up.
Yes.
The voice wasn't terrible either. What's going on here? Have we been bamboozled?
Yeah, has this been like worked on post its original release?
Yeah, is this like No Man's Sky? Is this a redemption story? Like a realm reborn?
Yeah, Chet, what made this game so bad?
I mean, like I said, when I was reading out of the reviews, Rock Paper Shotgun expressed the game's ideas, quote, seem nice on paper but are executed poorly, citing several haphazard gameplay functions and storyline moments. PC Gamer described the experience akin to an unfinished mod project with rudimentary level design, stating that they even doubted that planned bug fixes would fix the general quality of the levels I played. Although they were impressed by the initial cutscenes. All right, well,
that's where we are right now.
We might be going downhill from here. And then Yahtzee said this was the worst game of the decade, aside from Road to Hell, which he refused to rank in a hunger strike. How brave.
Apparently, Chet says I'm in the best part of the game.
So I mean, it should be
all downhill from here.
Shit. You should lead with your strongest foot, so...
That's true.
Yeah.
Do the developers know they made the worst game of the decade?
I mean, I think they keep making money based off idiots like us who download it.
Yeah.
Is there a second game from Birkin Swakowski?
Birkenstocks. I don't know. His name doesn't have a thing, so I'm guessing Royal Rubius Entertainment. Royal Rodius Entertainment. Let's see if they've done anything else. No, they have a YouTube channel that they haven't uploaded in 5 years. About Twitter.
Somebody in chat was saying they took advantage of a lot of people to make this game.
Oh.
Like who?
Like, is that why they're volunteer developers that never got paid?
Oh. He's been doing on Twitter, he's been doing a lot of those, you know, those TikTok things that are blowing up with the weird character with like the long neck who makes the weird noises.
What?
I'm not gonna repeat myself. I'll send it. I'll put a thing. Y'all know what's going on. I put it in chat.
They brought Crouch back. It looked like.
You know this guy, Casey, right? You click that link. You know that. You know that man in the toilet. You know that toilet man. You know the toilet man.
Oh, the link's in the chat. Oh.
Oh yeah. Sorry. I want to share with everyone. Everyone gets a little bit. Everyone gets the toilet man.
Am I tripping right now? It took me to your.
Marty's the toilet
took me
man.
To your page.
It shouldn't have. It shouldn't have.
Oh, I don't know why I did that.
What if I am the toilet man?
I've never seen this before.
You don't know who that toilet man is?
No.
Oh, he's like what big on this? He's big on TikTok. I don't know. Kids love the toilet man. Nick, you know what the toilet man is.
I have no idea what this is. No.
Chat, some please, just one person needs a single piece of validation to know that
what the toilet what, man what is part of TikTok.
Like, kids love this man.
Also, like, there's like two really tiny soldiers dancing in that clip before it goes into.
Where'd my gun go?
That was Skibbity Bee. Yeah, it's Skibbity Bee.
Where'd my gun go?
I nope. Want to know what's going on with those,
David,
baby soldiers.
David Dubois knows. Skibbity Bee, thank you so much.
No, it's bad. I don't like it.
Oh.
This is very dark.
I know. Get a flashlight.
Yeah. You don't in Half-Life you needed to turn it on. I don't know if that's the same here or if you just don't have one. Okay, we got a lot of head crabs.
Yeah, my gun just mysteriously disappeared. Game.
Is it gonna come back?
I think so. I'm so confused right now.
Yeah, like, are you supposed to be running from all this stuff?
Yes.
This is unless you're in the hospital, though, as opposed to Black Mesa.
Oh. Well, I guess after Gordon beat the shit out of you, you got taken to the hospital, and now you're going to go back to Black Mesa?
Yeah, because all those head crabs were in scrubs, so, like, yeah, maybe you are in a hospital.
Maybe Black Mesa has, like, a hospital. It's like the Mall of America. Or, like, Disneyland has a jail. not to be taken seriously... with $63.39.
Ooh.
I was trying to see if that got us to a funny number. It didn't, but I appreciate the donation anyway. You say, oh, wait, it just hasn't updated yet. And now we're at 5,000. If my math is right, we just need $12.65 an hour to reach the goal. Also, Gordon doesn't wear a helmet per the canon of Freeman's Mind. That's the main reason why this game sucks.
You're right.
Freeman's Mind is that YouTube series people really like and recommended to us, Casey, where the person was playing through the game and narrating it.
What are special forces doing here?
But the main reason the game sucks is because Freeman.
Where's
the
helmet?
Did his hair just change?
His hair, I feel like his hair changed.
It was probably longer because he's been in a coma.
But it didn't look that long in the start of the cutscene.
Also, chat, tell me this guy does not look like Nick.
No, he looks like Charlie Hunnam.
Maybe you look like Charlie Hunnam.
Also, this guy looks like a Fortnite man. As far as we know, we're under an alien
invasion. Oh, speaking of Nick, I was a couple weekends ago. I was at a bar with some pals, and there was a dude sitting alone who looked exactly like Nick. And I took a picture of him, and I felt bad because I took a picture of a stranger. But he looks like kind of chubby Nick. Casey, I'm gonna send it to you. I'm gonna send it to you, and I want you to let me know.
I don't get to see.
You're playing the game.
Like my food.
See you later.
Part of your punishment.
You get the game. We don't get audio. You don't get your doppelganger. Tell him Nick sent you.
Take this radio and map with the station. Hey, I'm in the game. Use it. Colonel Q.
Mitchell.
Godspeed, Mitchell.
What?
Hey, Mitchell. Welcome to Albuquerque.
Was that lab in New Mexico?
I believe like Black Mesa, all this stuff is New Mexico. Black Mesa is New Mexico. I don't think Half-Life 2 is New Mexico. I think that's supposed to be Europe.
Yeah, you keep saying that, but like, was there any proof?
What, that it was Eastern Europe?
Yeah, that City 17 was like in Europe somewhere.
No, I think chat was saying like one of the main artists on the game was Eastern European and inspired, a lot of stuff was inspired by that. Like, that had to be Eastern Europe, right? In Half-Life, like, that was in America.
Who knows?
Chat, sound off in the comments below.
Yeah, his organization calls heck you.
Okay, I think I sent it to you on Discord.
Let's see here.
Oh shit.
Doesn't he?
Ah,
he looks exactly like this.
I need to
this
see this.
Exactly like this.
No, I want to show me.
Nick, if I give it to you, can you somehow pull it off and show me the stream?
Yeah.
Okay, I'll send it to you as well.
Hold on, chat. You got to promise not to dox this guy.
Don't dox this man.
We don't know who this man is, and he doesn't want to be found. Okay?
He doesn't want to be found.
He makes vampire doppelganger alone.
You got to even add a hat too. Maybe you stole your hat.
Yo, that's just Nick.
That's just Nick. Okay, he's coming next.
Man, Devil says hunt the Nick man.
That's every game night. Every game night is hunt the Nick man.
I like when you kill the guys with a knife, they just swung at the door.
Why there's so much force in that knife swing?
Pills.
Pills here.
Can't shoot the guy. They're on my team.
And yeah, not to be taken seriously, thank you so much for updated. We are at 5,000. 83.33%. Thank you guys so much.
I bet you those threes go on forever.
God, that scope is awful. Oh my god, that immediately made me motion sick.
Hold on, Nick, you got to look at that scope. I need to see this.
Why is it? What is it doing?
Yeah, it's like bending space time.
It's laggy.
I hate it.
The scope is laggy.
Charge. What are these things?
This finder said, why was your knife making gunshot noises? That sounds really cool to me, to be honest.
What am I doing here? What's blowing up? What's going on?
It's no George Lucas, is this Levolution?
I don't hear anything.
Levolution. George Lucas recommended the scope for Siege.
Who are these big guys?
Is this an ACOG? I don't know what ACOGs are. Is this an ACOG?
Yes, I'm happy right now. What is this thing? I need to go look at what?
Yeah, what is that? That's not an enemy from Half-Life 1. This is something else.
I mean, if there was an alien invasion, maybe like a bunch of aliens came through.
But it wasn't an alien invasion. It was a conventional invasion, right?
I mean, there's still aliens, right?
I don't know if that counts.
The interdimensional beings aren't aliens?
I don't know. Like, have...
What do we call them then? Dementies?
That sounds like a slur.
That doesn't sound good.
I assume.
That doesn't sound like what Fox News is going to start calling them. Oh no, you got
just happened to me.
You got blinked.
What's going on? Where do I go? This way. We're going to go this
seems
way.
Like the lighting is taking you this way.
Mando says alien just means not of this earth, so yeah.
But what if they're from a different this earth in a different dimension?
Exactly, like, that's what I'm getting at. Like dimensions and parallel universe size.
Send me this picture on Discord.
It's a different thing.
Yeah, look at it.
Like if it's me from another dimension.
What the?
Sure, like an alien. Across the Spider-Verse. It looks like you, doesn't it, Nick?
Nick's watching.
I'm not crazy, right?
No, that just looks like Nick.
Yeah, it's just like you packed on some weight, you went on a little bender, you started drinking by yourself.
Lost my job. Oh god! It just ran in my face.
Yeah, like that's
you know what that is?
Dimension Nick.
So an alien. That's what's gonna happen if we don't hit the funding goal in 4 days. Nick's bosses will be like, well, you've done a really great job, but you got just behind the finish line, so. Oh, so this is the 7-hour war that is talked about.
That's referenced after Gordon comes back, right?
Yeah, it's sort of like what happened like after the first game, or I guess during the first game. These aliens invaded, and within 7 hours, they just like the Earth gave up.
So I mean that 7-hour war that started while Gordon was still in the lab.
I would assume so. I would assume it was
like that wasn't after he went on his little. Coma vacation or whatever the hell happened to him.
Yeah, I would assume it was either concurrent with one or like just after one. Chat, people who know what the 7-hour war is. Jinpan says, what if it takes you 7 hours to complete this part? Real time 7-hour war? That'd be great.
Versus one man, Mitchell.
Oh, killing the baby at the end of Half-Life 1, the big boss baby. Is what allowed the Combine to invade Earth. So
okay.
We were the reason.
So we triggered it.
Yeah, we triggered
it. So this isn't during Half-Life 1. This is after Half-Life 1.
Yeah, so are we going to travel through time to hunt the Freeman? I don't know what this gets about. I'm very excited.
Yeah, because if this is after that, then Gordon shouldn't be around, right? He was like
He would be in like time stasis.
Yeah, like limbo or something. Yeah. Nonsense.
Also, the skybox in this game is very ugly. What is going on up there? What's happening?
There's a big old anus up there.
Yeah, that's what I was about to say. Butthole up
Devil's
there.
Anus?
What happened?
It's a very specific time. Oh, 316? Austin 316? Hell yeah. Stone Cold.
They stole that from 24.
You know what else is in real time? Apple TV Plus's Hijack. If we want to talk about the real victim of this stream, a new episode of Hijack aired, and I haven't watched it because I'm fucking watching this. And people are going nuts about it. People are, show of the summer, only one episode left. Oh my god.
Really? I've heard none of this.
I've only heard you talk about Hijack. I'm pushing the narrative pretty heavily. It's great. Oh my god. Whoa. It's like a Russian nesting doll. And every time you've cracked it, you're opening it, you're like, this is gonna solve the mystery. You know what's inside?
I kind of hate that. That sounds awful. Just answer my questions, please.
I mean, it's only 7 hours, so in theory, next week they'll either end strongly or screw the pooch.
They're gonna end on a cliffhanger because they want you to come back for season two.
Yeah. Unless, what is it? Is he gonna be on another flight that gets hijacked? What are the odds of that? I guess it's like the odds of Sandra Bullock being on a bus that can't slow down and then being on a boat that can't slow down.
Did they not kill the guy who was up to these shenanigans in the first scene?
Like, how does this keep happening?
Also, the third one being called Cruise Control.
That was the second one, Speed 2 Cruise Control.
Oh, that was the second one, okay.
Yeah, there was only two. Oh. Yeah.
It's fucking brilliant, I'm gonna be honest.
It's really good, yeah, yeah.
That's channeling Fast and Furious title ending back then.
Yeah.
Fast and Furious adopted that.
That there's a second season that does end on a cliffhanger. How do we? You don't know any of that. It's not even out.
This is the longest new waiting for an out. Elevator last, ever.
Last episode's out until next week. Are you in the future, Jombly? What's going on? You got hijack scoops we don't have?
Jombly's a producer on that shit. Seriously.
Oh, unless Jombly was talking about possibly Twisted Metal, which is apparently out and good. The big two.
Well, Darren liked it. I don't know if that means that a thing is good. Like, I love Darren's opinions. I do not agree with all of them.
Big Multiverse of Madness fan. What are these elevator pictures? These are like real photos.
It is.
A video game couldn't capture these.
This is regular. This regular picture from something.
Is the same as this picture. But this picture is different from this picture.
Oh, incredible. They only had three.
Did you get an achievement for figuring that out?
Probably.
Oh, look at you.
Sam Fisher time.
Ooh. Is that helping?
Are you going to be going through time in this? Do we think there's time travel in this game?
Well, is there technically time travel in the core series?
Apparently, Alex is all about time travel.
It is about time. Okay, because I was going to say...
I said it was a prequel, and people got very mad at me. But apparently it's about time travel. Is that right, Nick? I should just throw it to you. You've played it. Is Alex about time travel?
I think so.
There you go. You heard it here first.
That's not a great answer.
You heard it here first.
But to be fair, I don't think the Half-Life story is... It's neither good nor coherent.
Yeah.
And if it was more coherent, it'd probably be a worse story than people are making it out to
be. It's funny, I'm gonna chalk us up to, I'm sure there's a lot of stuff we missed because we were talking and we were answering super chats and everything. But I feel like the 7-year war is something chat invented. I don't know if, or the 7-hour war, I don't think the game ever mentioned the 7-hour war. I feel like there's something chat kept being like, oh yeah, it happened during the 7-hour war. And we were just like, all right. That makes sense. Tom Junior says I'm throwing Alex spoilers for some reason. I haven't even played. I'm incapable of throwing.
Yeah,
Alex
like Marty
spoilers.
Does not know what he's talking about.
I thought it was about. Someone told me it was about time travel. I thought that was just like a thing. You're just going through time. Everything's about time travel.
I was gonna say because like yeah, there's no time travel in what we've played other than the fact that Gordon skipped time.
Yeah.
Like he lost a bunch of time, but like he still went forwards.
Is Rumpelstiltskin time travel? Because he's that dude who like. Isn't he the dude who like takes like a
what
fucking decade long nap?
Rumpelstiltskin? No.
Rumpelstiltskin? No, I thought he's like the dude who like he's like, I'm gonna go to bed forever.
You talking about Rip Van Winkle? Is that
I am thinking of Rip Van Winkle.
What?
I think the game's physics killed me. I think I got stuck between this desk and it just like said, you're squished.
Speaking of fucking Rip Van Winkle right there. I guess it's nice that the game decided you were dead instead of having to like finagle your way out of that thing. Who's Rumpelstiltskin then? If he's not the guy who time traveled,
Rumpelstiltskin is the one who comes to a crying girl who lied about being able to spin yarn into gold.
Oh,
and he goes like, "Promise me your baby or something, or guess my name, or I'll steal your baby." And everyone's like, "Wow, these stakes just escalated." He's like, I thought you were just gonna help me with my dilemma.
How did they
want my child?
How did they get it? Like, how did they guess? Because that's like a weird name. That's
I
not
forget.
Like David.
Yeah, they had to ask somebody.
Chat, do give me Rumpelstiltskin spoilers the same way I gave Half-Life Alyx spoilers.
If I remember correctly, they hired someone who went and spied on Rumpelstiltskin.
Private Eye. Is that why you became a PI? You were inspired by the Rumpelstiltskin lore.
Like, not another baby will not be taken on my watch.
I don't know if I just went the wrong way. I think I just went the wrong. I got an achievement for going the wrong way.
Incredible. This game thought of everything.
It also, like, there's explosion sounds, but it sounds like footsteps, and I'm.
Ah! Oh, whoa, confused. That was spooky.
Explosion footsteps?
Beastmarch with a $4.99 dono says, Marty, Yahtzee called this game the 7-hour snore, so chat was probably right. That's really clever. That's a good 7-hour war joke by calling this game the 7-hour chore. That guy's going places.
No.
He's going places, like his Ventures Nigh Side Quest 3. He's going places. Also, to Adventures Nigh Season 3. Episode 1, now out from members, and premiering Saturday morning for everyone. 11 a.m., is that right, Nick?
Yeah.
11 a.m. Central?
Yes.
I've become so brazen with time zones, I don't even say Central anymore. I just say the time, and I'm like, everyone will contort to me.
This level design is terrible.
This is, this level's bad. Everything I said, for as impressive as the first 20 minutes were, this level's bad.
Where the fuck am I going?
Yeah, this is a very big bland office building.
These doors also look weird. Like,
hold on, can you take off the night vision, or
yeah,
is that just what this is?
Completely dark.
Hold on, can I see for like a quick second?
Wait.
Oh, this is very dark.
Okay, I guess I just got to a cut.
Oh wait.
Oh, you took it off.
The timing of that is immaculate.
Well, it's pretty really good. Okay. Wait.
So. You're that sniper, huh?
Oh, this is the laser
Black
guy.
Ops.
There was a sniper up in the building at some point. And now it's him.
And you must be the one on the radio.
That's who we were playing as?
I heard that you guys have a plan about getting out.
Oh man, I got really confused suddenly.
Maybe.
I don't know what's going on in this game.
I want in. Why?
Yeah, shoot, dude. Hey, this is a new character too, or is this someone we're supposed
I'm
to recognize?
Listening.
Well, they're both from the cover art. The
wait, Mitchell has
from
a
the
plan?
Thumbnail.
The only plan was to kill Gordon.
But they're gonna have to travel through time, so I bet their plan's gonna be time travel.
Give you sniper support, but I want in. I'm getting the hell out of this.
I can get you to Brandon Street. That's not a street name.
So whatever your plan is, I'm in. When we're out, I'll go my own way. Until then, I'm the only friend you got.
So tell me, Mr. Black Ops, why?
Nick, do you think this? Would you rather have this or side quest cutscenes from Final Fantasy 16?
Adam.
What?
Side quest cutscenes.
My name is Adam. and we just followed orders. They sent us to do the job.
Because you like that dog. You like that torgo.
I know what game Marty's playing for his punishment game. Got there, you guys
already killed more than half the blood. Oh, I thought this was part of it. Wait a minute.
I'm going to make you play Road Warrior. Wait a minute.
Face it, Mitchell. Rogue Warrior.
Yeah, that Bethesda game that got a Game Informer cover story and it got a 1 out of 10. Told you it
was in order. Ooh, that's not good. Oh, this guy just looks like the Punisher. This guy in the art, this just looks like the Punisher. How did you make it alive from Black Mesa? Oh, no.
I found my way back. How did you get out?
Yeah, I'll play this game.
Well, I guess I found my way back.
How did you find your way back? Well, I guess I found my way back. We got a deal or
what? Well,
so we got it.
All right, then. Let's get the hell out of this goddamn city.
But next time I go to a buddy's house, how'd you get here? I found my way here.
I got a Rogue Warrior. Rogue Warrior tip for you guys. First off, main character. Oh my god, I still had fucking toilet head open in a window and I clicked over there and it started yelling at me. Main character voiced by Mickey Rourke. And his name is Richard Demo Dick Machinko.
Oh, hey.
Oh, Marcinko. Well, anyways, I'm copy and pasting this from the Steam description. The main character of Rogue Warrior's name is Richard Demo Dick Machinko.
Yeah. Because his name is Richard, I guess you can call Richard Dick.
Well, where's the demo? Demolition?
I guess.
Richard like, Demolition that's Man. Dick.
Like, someone was like, "Oh, this is a cool nickname for a soldiery guy who does like demolition." Frank Button, right? But then you just put that in the middle of his name, and it's like that doesn't work anymore.
Old Demo Dick. Yeah, Mickey Rourke. Also, it's insane because I think this game came out the year after he got the Academy Award for The Wrestler. What are you doing, dude? Mickey Rourke.
You probably did a bunch of stuff that year, and like it just
turns
came
out.
One of them
stuck.
Is this the same canal that we did all that boating around in?
Kind of seems like it.
Wait, no, that was Half-Life 2, though. Well, it's right? Closed.
Oh, Half-Life 2 was boating around. Yeah, yeah, we didn't have vehicles in Half-Life 1.
But this came out prior. In the interim years, No.
This game?
Yeah.
2018. 2018. 3 years.
Good reason.
First off, I said 3 years ago, which that is not how time works. Oh yeah, 5 years ago. See, this is until Alex. This was the newest. Okay, with the preface, this isn't real. this isn't real. You're doing great.
This game has no objective things.
It's immersive.
Yeah, it's an immersive sim. You keep saying you want those. Here you go.
That was a funny thing. The shooting actually feels really good. Everything else
is
really bad.
What, like,
you gotta try this on it.
No,
because that's just a mouse. Like, the shooting can't feel good unless it works on a controller. That's all.
What happened? That there was like a weird game. It is crazy to me that this game was sold for money. Did you have to buy it, Nick?
Yes.
Do you know how much you paid?
$10.
So this game was sold for $10 on Steam. It just uses Valve's intellectual property. Valve's just fucking fine with it.
Yeah, they're like, we don't care.
Oh, this is yeah. Open. I mean, I guess they're getting a kick. They're getting a piece of the pie. So
that was a mission.
Like, in a sense, isn't that what we want? Like, we want these big companies that own these IPs to let them free, like let people do stuff with them.
It's like the opposite of how litigious Nintendo is with someone trying to do a remake of a game from 30 years ago that they haven't re-released.
But I guess this is the sort of thing Nintendo is afraid of, is that someone's gonna release a real shitty Mario game and folks are gonna be like, oh no. I don't like Mario, last one I played was that.
That's why they released a closed off environment with Super Mario Maker.
Yeah. Oh, look at this portal.
Where did my ammo go? I just had a bunch of ammo. I got pills.
Pills here.
Hit him with the bottle.
Hit him with the bottle.
Guys, die so I can take your ammo.
three question marks. It says, bold of you to assume they even bothered to include controllers.
I mean, that would be in line with the rest of the the Valve Half-Life properties, so.
With Black Mesa.
I can jump over everything like, besides the stupid railing.
Control support, seriously. You know what did take control support seriously?
Portal. Perfect Dark. Oh, Portal.
Oh, you Perfect Dark too.
I was gonna say Perfect Dark. Portal. By the way, we are starting next week. From today, Casey and I will be starting Portal 1.
This game forgot to do lighting in a lot of areas.
It did. I'm noticing a lot of areas are very dark.
Did you throw your night vision goggles away?
No.
Like I, it looked like you took them off your face and just chucked them.
He traded them for a bottle of pills. there's a robust trading sequence in this game.
I think the soldier was mad because I didn't give him an order because he just said order. Kiss our asses goodbye. Got it. Oh, now they're dead.
Deep's portal is good shit. I agree.
We can get demonetized because I'm taking pills on stream.
Probably. Only in certain countries.
Australia? Amy will never be able to watch this.
They hate
but she's
that.
In New Zealand, so she'll be fine.
Ammo. Equip parkour.
Parkour! Kamjanin just says, for context, Black Mesa had to change its name because Valve wanted the project, wanted to protect their copyrights, and they liked Black Mesa. 15 years later, they let this game, which uses Half-Life assets, sell for full price. So yeah, that's,
Whoa, I just shot my own guy.
Guess that's how a company changes over time.
Hmm.
Deebs, yes, Casey has played Portal 1 and 2. That's right, right, Casey?
Yes.
Oh,
that was an issue. It's the co-op. Portion of Portal 3 that I've not played.
Is that what you guys are playing?
And that does have like some story significance.
It does. It is canonical.
Why does the game keep giving me the console when I get to the next?
It is weird. It's weird. It is really weird. I noticed that. Last cost. I've not caught up with the Nier anime. No, the only anime I'm watching now is Hijack.
Didn't the Nier anime like stop making episodes or something?
For a while, yeah. They would be. They were like we. We are behind and we are stopping because of COVID. And I was like, well, that's a weird reason. eventually they did finish it. I think they said there was going to be a second season.
God, what is happening?
Yeah, like,
why is your gun floating in front of you?
I picked it up and I'm just running with it.
He just picked it up off the ground, but like he won't use it.
why are you so short? Why are you? You were like 3 feet tall. You were
these
just
are giant aliens.
Gun. Oh, I thought those were men.
It's like the game wants to give me a gun, and then it's like, nah, you can't actually use this.
Gildan says that gun was Nick's David. This is your David. You have to take your gun to the end of the game.
Yeah, that's what it's like. It's a truck full of guns and ammo, but like it's a prop that he can't actually equip.
That's also very funny.
That's really funny.
I think that I already forgot his name. Justin Davalovsky.
Birkin Champagne.
Fucking I keep having it open, then I click over and it's the toilet man again. I think Birkin Denizarian has a very good sense of humor. I think he has a secretly great sense of humor. What? Oh. Ow.
This is doom now.
I think the circle overlay thing is because we're wearing night vision.
Yes.
And when they showed it in a cutscene earlier, it was like a single green dot in the middle of it. Why contain it? I have considered closing the toilet man, but I don't know if he might come in handy later on. Maybe someone later on in the chat will be like, I wasn't here for toilet man. Can I see toilet man? And I'll have him in my toolbar.
Fair.
9C says Birkin got a job at Activision because of this game. I feel I'm like 90% sure that's a joke.
Though you kind of, well, not single-handedly, but you put your name front and center on like a fully released finished video game, like that does go on a resume.
Yeah, yeah.
is the worst game.
That's I mean, worst yeah, game there's ever. That. Like, I wonder, like, yeah, I was very curious, like, is this person still making games? But, like you said, you don't really see them, like, the studio at least isn't, but, like, maybe them individually, they joined a team somewhere. Who knows?
Yeah. Maybe, like, someday we're going to finish a game that we really love, and we're going to sit through the credits, and we'll be like, oh, damn, look, it's Birkin. He did it.
The mastermind of Hunt Down the Freeman.
It says official account of the popular abandonware game Hunt Down the Freeman. It's not abandonware. It's if it's on sale for $10.
It came out like 5 years ago too.
Yeah. Because several people, including Deebs, said you're in luck. We don't know who Toilet Man is. I'm sending you guys Toilet Man.
Where did this guy come from? Why does he have a vent just sitting on him?
What the? That vent is huge. Like, that's the biggest vent cover to exist in this entire world.
It's a really big vent cover.
Get out of my way.
This looks like you are a snake. Like, you... Oh, okay. No. Like, when you're holding it, it looks like first-person, like, snake vision.
Stupid head crabs. I like VR better because I can just grab them and throw them.
Ah! Little popcorn boys.
They didn't need to do that either, right? Like the loading screens between zones, like that was like for nostalgia purposes.
I imagine so. Yeah.
Yeah, in 2018, you don't need to do that.
Yeah.
Oh, the D-scrubs. Why is Toilet Man?
That was our entire room full of claymores.
That was so many mines. For a second, I was like, whoa, what are all these things on the ground? I was like, oh, no, those are mines.
You can, like, shoot them from, like, across the room, right?
Yeah, if you shoot one, maybe all of them explode from a safe distance.
Freaking daisy chain.
Maybe if you follow the cables, you can shoot the main switch.
Who built this?
Is that the main switch? Up on the wall?
I got a parkour to get up there.
Well, they said shoot the main switch, right?
You think this is a switch? That looked like a switch to you, Marty?
And follow the cables to the main switch!
Shoot it, Marty.
Switches come in all shapes and sizes.
Mando like says C4 doesn't explode from being shot.
Is that like a...
Proved you wrong.
Snopes. That was a suicidal Snopes.
Want to rethink that? Oh, it wants me to... Look, there's a handprint up there for me to climb.
Oh, that's good environment. That's good, like, training the player's eye. Wait, that doesn't make any sense. Oh, look at you. You're shimmying. This is like, he had to put this in the game. He couldn't have stolen this from Half-Life. There was no shimmying in Half-Life.
What? Oh, there's headcrabs down there.
How about if that guy trips one, then everybody dies, right?
Right, we never did this in Half-Life. There was no shimmying to be had.
There's lots of vent work, though. That's the closest we got to shimmy.
How do I get down? Oh.
Oh, no.
Wires. Just gotta keep following the cables. There's two sets of wires down there.
Oh, no.
Good job.
It feels like enemies go down much easier in this game than in regular Half-Life, which is good. Oh, you gotta go on the vent? Oh, yeah! Look at you!
There you go. Now it feels like Half-Life. Fungus Finder asking, can you quicksave in this game?
Looks too good for quicksave.
Yeah, I don't need that. I'll finish this game in 2 hours. I finished Gears of War Judgment like 40 minutes into the stream today, so...
Yes, that's what, under 5 hours?
Ow!
4.5 hours for me.
Yeah, so I beat it faster than the guy you said I couldn't beat faster than.
What is the world record for hunt down the Freeman?
Oh, that's good.
This should do it.
Speedrun record, speedrun.com, hunt down the Freeman. Looks like 1 hour and 4 minutes.
Damn.
Well done, terrors.
So how long is it to beat normally then?
That was in front of me.
There's various categories in speedrunning, including soft lock percentage, crash percentage, which is 0 minutes, 0 seconds, 0.001 milliseconds.